By the rivers of Babylon, there we sat down. Yea, we wept when we remembered Zion. Remember, O Lord, the children of Edom in the day of Jerusalem, who said, raise it even to the foundation. O daughter of Babylon, who art to be destroyed, happy shall he be that rewardeth thee as thou hast served us. Happy shall he be that taketh and dasheth thy little ones against the stones. Do you know what it means? Given those two choices, yes. In the best of all possible worlds, they would just leave us in peace. But they won't. I don't enjoy killing, but when done righteously, it's just a chore, like any other. Practiced hands make for short work, and the good Lord knows there's much to be done here. Happy are those who do the work of the Lord. Zion belongs to God and the people of God. It is a natural temple and monument to his glory. When our Lord entered the temple and found it polluted by money changers and beasts, did he ask them to leave? Did he cry? Did he simply walk away? No. He drove them out. It is one thing to forgive a slap across my cheek, but an insult to the Lord requires... No, it demands correction. You're not so certain. Fair enough. We all have doubts. Blessed are they that have not seen, and yet have believed. But you can be a Thomas for now. Fight the white legs enough, and you'll see the truth. I just hope that by the time you understand, there will still be time to convince Daniel that we have to fight for Zion, to save it and the sorrows.
What's your nationality?
Christian.
I mean, I'm not American, your religion, but not I guess I'm religion. Like German. I don't fucking know what I am. Right.
All right. From your father's side, you'll be German.
I'm American.
All right, so
I'm a white American.
Okay, so you would be an Edomite.
Okay.
An Edomite according to the Bible.
Okay.
So German was not, we're talking about the
we're
Bible.
Not even
so we're going to go by Bible terms. We're not going to go by Westernized
terms,
all right? So Romans 9 and 13.
Uh-huh.
This is out of the Bible.
Okay. So because we're not on
no,
there,
no, 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 hey, let me
just like it's way out of order.
Right. I know what you mean.
This is the book of Romans, chapter 9, verse 13.
I'm going to try.
As it is written, Jacob have I loved, but Esau have I hated.
Esau have I hated. So the Most High God of the Bible said he loves one person and he hates another person.
Okay.
He said, Jacob have I loved. These people represent Jacob, the Israelites, the true Jews of the Bible. No, these are the God-given names. So this is what the white man called us.
They don't love us.
This is what the white man called us.
We're white, blonde, hair.
They said we're Negro.
They don't love us.
You are an Edomite.
Thus saith the Lord God, because that Edom hath dealt against the house of Judah by taking vengeance, and hath greatly offended, and revenged himself upon them. Therefore thus saith the Lord God, I will also stretch out mine hand upon Edom, and will cut off man and beast from it, and I will make it desolate from Teman, and they of Dedan shall fall by the sword. And I will lay my vengeance upon Edom by the hand of my people Israel, and they shall do in Edom, according to mine anger and according to my fury, and they shall know my vengeance, saith the Lord God. But thou art cast out of thy grave like an abominable branch, and as the raiment of those that are slain, thrust through with a sword that go down to the stones of the pit, as a carcass trodden under feet. Thou shalt not be joined with them in burial, because thou hast destroyed thy land and slain thy people. The seed of evildoers shall never be renowned. Prepare slaughter for his children for the iniquity of their fathers, that they do not rise, nor possess the land, nor fill the face of the world with cities.